Matthew, let me come to you. Talk to us about the, you know, the products that NSSF has that people from the diaspora can come in and buy or even tap into.
Thank you, Solomon. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Our primary focus is on the residential and the commercial space. Okay. Within that space, we are in it as developers. The kind of product that we build will sell and will make money for the member. Presently, the current products that we have include a housing 3.5-bed apartment, 40 high-end apartments in Mbuya. In the pipeline, we have the Luboa project. In the pipeline, we have a Temagalo project. We have a Chanja housing project. All these, similar to my colleagues' projects, are meant to serve a need. The challenges for the diasporans was that sending money home, you wouldn't be sure that it was going to get invested. But now you have more professionals, more developers in the market whose entire brand and existence depends on not cheating the customer. So people now can buy from their desktops.
Let me ask you just a quick one. Is this only for the members, or even if you're not a member, you can actually buy some of these houses?
Okay. It's a business arm, business unit within the fund, okay? Meant to build the product for that Kakira sugar worker who has been working 10 years but can't afford to buy a piece of land in Mbuya. So we buy the piece of land in Mbuya on his behalf. We build a product on that piece of land on his behalf, and we sell the product on his behalf. Because individually, as a Kakira sugar worker, as a primary school teacher, he can't invest in the real estate space. But collectively, there's real power in the numbers.
Thanks.